Welcome back to the campaign map in my 10th episode of my first ever Let's Play featuring Sweden in Empire Total War. I just defended Estonia and Livonia in a battle against Poland-Lithuania, and it really wasn't no contest. As you can see, I had more troops than him. Plus I had bayonets, he didn't have bayonets, and he used his units stupidly so they were exhausted when they reached the walls. Basically, I don't know why he did that. He might have thought that, you know, this is a fair chance, but I had settlement fortifications, so he didn't have any chance at all. And contrary to what I actually thought, my general did manage to get away. As you can see in the background, he wasn't dead. Which is a very good thing, at least that's what I think. So, maybe he's gotten some experience as well, or maybe he's become a coward since he ran away. Who knows? And the great arsenal is finished in Sweden. This is great because now I can build 12-pound howitzers. And 12-pound howitzers are great for shooting over your own troops. You can place them behind your army at any time and it's no problem at all. Now, I do want to conquer some... I want to take over some of these other trading things. Looks like I got 3 out of 5. Again, that's very good. Now, I do not know if the pirates are still here. I'm going to assume they are until I've actually managed to defeat them. So I think it's about time that I'm making an army to defeat them. Replenishing all my troops. Still quite a few wounded from the battle in Copenhagen. Now my general was quite wounded. He has eight people left. That's that's not a whole lot, is it? Now I do need to build up an ordnance factory here again. It's about time, actually. So I can just make armies over here. I don't have to make them in Sweden and send them all the way over. Because for that I need, well, if I want to send them quickly, I need naval superiority, and I might not always have that. So I really should have a recruitment center in both places. I also need to build some of these shipyards that I still haven't built. Now, what will those guys do for sending them away? Okay. Huh. You know what? That's acceptable. That's perfectly acceptable for me. And as you can see, I am sending these guys to take Courland. I'm going to take back Courland, which I gave to Poland-Lithuania in exchange for peace, and they backstabbed me. So I'm now going to take Courland back. And this time, I'm not giving it away. It's going to be mine. And I'm considering what else to take from him as punishment for his blasphemy. He doesn't have a fortress in Vilnius, so I might just take Vilnius. However, I do not want to conquer the whole of Poland-Lithuania. What am I supposed to do with Minsk and Lvov and Warsaw? Warsaw will put me between... will put Prussia between me and the coast. And I do not want to mess with Prussia. I want to be friends with Prussia, so I'm not going to do that. I need something that's connected to the coast directly. And Vilnius is one province away from the coast, so that's fine. However, Minsk is too many. It's one, two provinces away. I don't want that. I'm going to use the Baltic Sea as my... what should I call it? Well, I want to conquer all around the Baltic Sea. I want to control the Baltic Sea. However, Prussia is going to control the German side of the Baltic Sea and some of the Polish ones. However, I'll take the Baltic countries and that should be enough for me. still making more Inhuman. You know, trade is very important. At least I feel it's very important to get some good money. Very good money. And it's an easy way to get money, although I do need quite a navy to defend it, which is why I'm still researching for that. So, that's something I've forgotten to do. I do need to upgrade my schools, and I am just going to try and get rid of this guy. He's really annoying me. Well, would you look at that. The Swedes have learned, and I've actually started to win their duels. Oh, great. Oh, joy. That's what I like to see. Now, who's in control here? Okay, so we still have some, let's call them Native Americans, who are controlling some of the territories here. However, the coastlines are kept by Great Britain and France. So I do not think I'll try and conquer this area just yet. I might take this one. Actually, yeah, I might do that. Who knows? However, I am going to conquer the pirate island over here. And if I ever come into war with Spain, I'll conquer all these territories in the West Indies. Ah, there's so many good ones here. And Texas, I can take Texas. So, this is just my planning for the New World, what I should take and what I shouldn't. I don't really want to mess with the Maratha Confederacy. I might do that eventually, but not yet. Mysore is always a good place, though. I could always attack Mysore and get that. You see, yeah. Oh, tea plantations and gold mines and gem mines. It's a very rich territory. Decisions, decisions, decisions. My agent is still on the way to Sweden, which is always good to see. It also looks like the Ottoman Turks have taken, well, the Ottoman Empire have taken Crimea from Russia. That is, if you can see on the minimap, where I'm pointing right now, this little, peninsula right here, and the provinces around. This will deny Russia a port, because Russia had quite a sizable fleet, but, Okay, this is the little country that I said I was worried about earlier when I was going to take Denmark, because these are the guys south of Denmark. And apparently they don't like me, so they're going to try and steal Denmark from me. And, wow. They could do that in one turn. That's, okay, fine. Whatever. I'll take back Copenhagen. And I'll make Hanover pay. I'll make them pay. Oh, the shame. The shame. However, revenge will be swift. It will be merciless. And it will be without hesitation. Now, I shouldn't have done that. I should have just crushed them, shouldn't I? Huh. Well, I'll crush them anyway. It still surprises me how many people you lose when you auto resolve matches that should be very easy to win. Ah, yes. Now, the way I did this to look at all these trade ports to see who's taken or not is I sent it along the central line, because you can see that one is taken, obviously. This one is not taken, that one is taken, and that one is not taken. As you can see, this line splits up, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4 here. One of them might be taken by some country who doesn't have a navy nearby. Or who doesn't have a port, rather. So, for example, Russia might be one of these. As you can see in Brazil, there's no trading line going to the Russian fleet over here. Because they lost their port in Crimea. Yeah, it's actually cold from here in this game as well. That's nice. There's still this little province, but there's no port around here. Which is quite weird, but... Now, I have a significant amount of money. What I want to spend it on. I want to improve my settlement fortifications in Ingria. I want to build a star fort over there. I really do. I feel like that's something I need. However, I want royal observatories first. And I almost forgot again. Upgrade my schools. Now, does Hanover, do they have a fleet? They do not, because their harbour village hasn't grown yet. I am going to take Hanover. I'm going to make them pay for their impudence. And I could barely afford to build a shipyard there. That is perfect. That is, yeah, that's just absolutely perfect. Oh. Yes, well, you know, they're German. Ordnung muss sein! So... It's not really surprising that they're the first country to do a proper census of their population. Now, he honestly has a cannon in here, and I have quite... I'm going to wait one more turn until my general is fully replenished. That way I won't lose him. He might reinforce that area in the meantime, but I don't really care. Courland doesn't have a settlement fortification, as far as I know. So, yeah, they don't. So, it's easy to hold Estonia and Livonia until I'm done punishing Hanover. What do I have over here? I don't need these guys. It's a money drain. Don't need them at all. Disband. Yes. Okay. Now, I need to... they're not that happy over here. So I need to upgrade some happiness buildings. Once again, that's whorehouses and all that kind of stuff. I might make a royal observatory over there. Actually, yeah, I will make a royal observatory. Wow, Prussia still has a sizable fleet in, well, in West Africa, that was. It's great. I love seeing that. I love seeing that they're actually building a fleet or a navy. Yes, I've stopped calling it a marine. I actually got that through my head that it's not a marine, it's a navy. Because marine just means anything on the sea, so... Looks like we might have another fully pitched siege battle. Which is good. Combines. Oh yeah, my military syllabus thing is done. This means I can upgrade my barracks to drill school. Which is always fun. Now, one thing I do want to do is I want to build howitzers. 3 12-pound howitzers, to be exact. They're gonna reinforce this army over here. These guys are cornered, shouldn't be able to get away. And yes, they are crushed. Now, once again, he might just be able to run all the way to Denmark again. To Copenhagen. If so, that's a hell of a marathon. But he might be able to. Who knows? Once again, I don't really care though. That's fine with me. He can do that if he feels like it. This fleet I'm sending up here to make ready for when my howitzers are done. So they'll come straight to Copenhagen and help him out. Still no reinforcements here in Courland, so I'll take Courland. Perfect. And he refuses to surrender, so... Victory in the name of Sweden. Catholic mercenary. No, Catholic missionary. Protestantism is falling as the main religion. How's it doing in Ingria? Because I know this is where my priest is, missionary is. I'll let them grow to 100%. He might just send away his missionary now that I took it over. I took it for myself. I do love that when you use ports, you can just keep moving on the same turn, because you just dock and disembark your army in a proper port, and they can keep moving. It's not like you have to land them with small boats and everything. And that's very realistic and very good thing, I feel. Okay, and there we go. Doing some division of labor, so I can actually start building plantations and commercial ports. I still haven't started building my army over here, because new things keep popping up. Actually, no. You go to the East Indies so I can secure more trading thingies. As will you. There we go. Okay, let's see what Poland-Lithuania does. If they rage out, or if Hanover tries to sneak in and take Denmark once again. In a useless gesture, but they might just do it anyway. Naval battles. Always fun. I do not know how they can afford navies that big. Or fleets that big. I have no idea. The AI must get some kind of economical boost in this game. Which they often did in the earlier Total War games. I don't think they do anymore. At least not as drastic. But they do in these games. And I think almost all of India belongs to the Maratha Confederacy, except for one province, at least that's what I managed to glimpse. And my trading route is being raided by the bloody pirates, so I think it's about time I focus on taking them down. Jorgen Morgan. It's Captain Morgan, is it? Oh well. Time to recruit an army and make them pay. Ah, my howitzers are done. I love that it only takes one turn. I'm going to send three of my most wounded units, or my most damaged units, down. I'm going to send one cavalry and two line infantry. That way it keeps my line infantry as an even number. There we go. No problem at all. Ah, my ordnance factory is done in Ingria. So I'll upgrade that one to a, what's it called? A great arsenal later. And Cornan is very unhappy with being conquered, they don't like that. Fine, I'll turn off the taxes here. Just to make you shut up. Now, 3 turns until Ingria is completely Protestant. And this guy's just staying here making Colin unhappy. Looks like I could attack him, but I don't think I can. Unfortunately. This guy, though. I have a sloop or something. Brig, I have a brig over here. I'll send my rake over and maybe try and kill him. Oh yes, I have this one. That's true. I knew I had a sloop somewhere. Yeah, it'll take a turn, so I'll just leave him there anyway. Now, my Indiaman. You go. Actually, it might be quicker or something that way. Who knows? Yes, once again, that's Corland being very unhappy. Now, Russia still hasn't backstabbed me, and I'm earning quite a lot of money each turn, so this is just getting interesting. Now, please let me know if these, if the end turn while showing the CPU moves, is us, if that gets way too annoying, because I can always just cut it out when I'm editing this. I could just clip it, you know, cut it out so you don't have to watch this at all. So please let me know, either by commenting or sending me a private message on the forums or anything. But I like to see what the enemy does, especially when he can't load because you didn't notice something. So it's very handy, and I want to keep it. So I'm going to keep it, but you might not want to see it. So just let me know. Now, these guys are probably trying to find a port. I don't know if Russia has a port in the north. I don't think it does. I'll check, though, just to make sure. And, oh, here we go. My army is not completely replenished yet, so I'm going to wait, actually. I'm going to retreat until they are fully replenished, which will be the turn that starts now. There's no good reason behind this. I just don't like fighting with the, you know, units that have lost some guys in them, because the formations won't be as good and stuff like that. It's just a silly reason, I know, but that's my reasoning, and I'm sticking to it. So, character shot. What is this? Ah, yes. That. Oh, that is nasty. That is really nasty. Huh. Basically makes them more expensive to recruit, but less upkeep. It's a good trade, in my opinion. Sextant. Extra movement on the campaign map is always good. Now, I think it's that one and that one who's still not taken. Although I'm not 100% sure. No, that one is taken, so it's this one that's free. And yeah, it is, so. Good deal, good deal. Nice. Oh, I love seeing that money come in. Now, time to upgrade my shipyards. I'll make two upgraded ones in Denmark. And how is my little army doing? It is now fully replenished and ready to do some damage. Which it is going to. Now he might just attack me, like he did last time. So I'm going to stand right here and see if he chooses to attack me. That would be quite fun. This way I can have a bridge battle. Since I can't reach his town this turn anyway. Ah, yes, this is true. I'm still recruiting in the Caribbean Isles. One. Okay, so I guess four of those, two houses, and the Colonial Light Cavalry should be enough. These guys still aren't retrained, are they? No, I can afford that next turn anyway. Okay. Industrial genius. Yes, all looks good. Okay. It's all good. Oh, I forgot about my rake. Sent him to try and take out his missionary. The Poland-Lithuanian missionary. Who was being really annoying and trying to convert people into Catholicism. Catholicism. Sorry. And he shall die. For spreading this false religion. Okay. Good to go, good to go. Ankara. I knew it was about time. Well, Okay. Have fun with that. You're getting your ass handed to you by the Ottoman Empire anyway, so. He has his navy though. That's not nice, because I still haven't got my new ships yet. And there we go. So it looks like I'll have a big battle with Hanover. So I will see you on the campaign map. No, not on the campaign map, on the battle map. Sorry.